Today at JW Pepper, I want to talk about what I think is a great sounding and affordable microphone pair that can give pro results for everything from rehearsals to performances and recordings. And I'm going to give some tips on how you can get great results using these microphones. Let's get started. Recording your ensemble is something that almost every director or teacher will come across at least once in their career. Maybe you want to record your performance at the spring concert, or you need to record a student audition for Allstate, or maybe you just want to record rehearsals to go back and analyze them. Something you should be doing, by the way. Well, you will need microphones to do this, and in this video, we'll go over a pair that I think are great. But first, just a couple disclaimers here to get out of the way. This entire video and most of the videos we produce like this are usually my personal opinion on these products as I've used them in the real world. I'm a musician, I've taught music at the high school level, and I have some knowledge in audio video production, but I'm not an audio engineer. This overview is not going to dive into the subtle noise floor levels or the nuances that audio engineers might get into in very detailed reviews. This video, again, like all of ours at JW Pepper, are designed for music teachers and directors or students who want to get the most out of their tools, need help using those tools, or want to see what can be achieved using them. And today, I want to share with you the Samson CO2 stereo microphone pair, because I've used them and continue to use them extensively in all kinds of scenarios. The Samson CO2 microphones are a lightweight and compact cardioid microphone pair that are designed to be used as a pair to get great stereo recordings. A cardioid pattern microphone is one that picks up sound across the front of the microphone but diminishes as you get to the back of it. A cardioid pickup pattern looks like a heart shape coming from the front of the microphone. This will come into play in some of the use cases later on in this video. The Samson CO2s are condenser XLR microphones, which means they will need some type of 48 volt phantom power to operate, which most PA systems or recorders have equipped in them. They're very sensitive, which makes them great for getting a good sound but keeping the noise level low. The build quality is very professional. They have a brass metal outer frame and come with shock mount microphone clips to ensure no vibration comes through the microphone. Also included are foam windscreens and a carrying case to keep your pair together. All of this for an amazing, affordable price. Probably the best price versus performance in the world of stereo microphone pairs. As I've mentioned, I've used these and continue to use them in a variety of settings to record both choir and instrumental ensembles and even broadcast voiceover. In fact, the entire audio in this video has been recorded using one of these Samson CO2 microphones as a boom mic, so you can judge for yourself just how good the quality is for this use. Before we give some examples of these microphones being used to record choirs or orchestras, let's first talk about why there are two microphones. Again, I'm not an audio engineer, so I'll try and keep this short and to the point. But normally with live performances like choirs or bands or strings or any live audio, you want to try and capture the most immersive sound quality you can, and usually expanding that sound into stereo is a great way to achieve this. To get a good stereo sound, you will need two microphones, and normally they should be a matched pair. Stereo configurations can be done in a number of different ways, but we'll cover two very common and easy to replicate techniques today. And this should be stated as well, the two best ways to get a good sound from any microphone is microphone placement and listening back. Even just moving your microphones a few feet back or forth can make a huge difference, and then listen back to those results and trust your ear to tell you what sounds good or not. To get started, let's go over the basic setup you'll need to use these mics. All of these products that we're talking about today are available at jwpepper.com, and links to each of them are in the description below. First, we'll need the Samson CO2 stereo microphone pair. Two XLR cables to connect the microphones. One microphone stand, preferred a boom stand, but a straight stand will work. One stereo microphone bar to mount the microphones to the stand. One recorder or camera that accepts XLR inputs. We offer many options at jwpepper.com, but for this example, we're going to use the Q8 Handy Video Recorder, which we have a video linked for here. And finally, one pair of headphones for listening back to your audio. Some of the recorders that we offer at JW Pepper, including the H8, or the Q8 that I'm using in this example come with a built-in stereo microphone set up in the XY configuration that we're about to show. However, another reason to consider a separate microphone pair like the CO2s, even with these recorders, is the ability to start and stop the recording or monitor it once you've started. Sometimes you need to place those microphones closer to the group but the recorder far away, which I can tell you is almost all the time. So to get set up, first we connect the stereo mic bar to the mic stand. The stereo mic bar will allow us to configure the mics into different stereo patterns. Next, you can connect the XLR microphones to the mics. It helps to use Velcro ties to hold the mic cables in place. Attach the XLR cables to the recorder inputs and use the gain knobs to adjust the volume. This is the basic setup that you will use, and depending on what type of ensemble, you can space out the microphones accordingly. The first type of stereo mic placement, and probably the most widely used and easiest to get a good result, is the XY stereo setup that we mentioned already. This places the microphones at a 90-degree angle with the heads or the capsules of the mic crossing each other to make this pattern. For this setup, you will usually keep the microphones closer to the ensemble and at a higher position to capture that full sound. For choirs, I would suggest taking an additional few steps away from the front singers to make sure you don't capture individual voices in the front row. Usually, about a foot or two above the singer's mouths is good, and for instrumental ensembles, size of the group and placement will play a huge part, especially with acoustic drums. A quick and easy starting point is to position the microphones right above the head of the conductor, which is good because the conductor is used to hearing the group and adjusting for this position. Here's an example of this method. These exact microphones and this exact setup were used to capture this sound. Just note, before I show any of these examples, a lot of these examples were recorded in the last year when setups were less than ideal. Sometimes choirs were in the audience, and the conductor was on stage, sometimes in ballrooms and not in auditoriums or concert halls, sometimes even in parking garages. But I want to show you this because the sound that these CO2 microphones were able to capture, even in these not so ideal setups, was still very good and something I think most people would be happy with. As you can see, the orchestra was in a ballroom and spread out a lot, but the sound is still very good, and the director was happy with these recordings, which just shows off the strength and versatility of these Samson CO2 mics. Now let's show a different setup for these microphones, which is called an ORTF setup, and I'll leave that acronym on the screen below and not try to pronounce it here for you. ORTF actually gets its name from a French public radio and television broadcast company. This is another option to get a good stereo sound. I also used this last winter while making these recordings, again, mainly to deal with some of these very odd setups. The microphones are still on the stereo mic bar, but this time the front of the mics, or the capsules, are spread out to a 110-degree angle, and you're usually about 17 centimeters apart. This puts both of those cardioid heart-shaped patterns that we talked about earlier in a direction that can capture their own sound, but also still close enough to capture a stereo image. I used this setup in this example where the choir was in an LGI room, not a stage or even an auditorium, and they were spread out very far apart, so much that I couldn't even fit them in one shot for the video. But I was able to get a good stereo sound that captured the entire room. another example of the ORTF stereo setup in a parking garage. And yes, cars were driving in and out. And yes, there was a bird's nest chirping very loudly. But the Samson CO2 microphones delivered a good result and something that, again, the director was happy with, even in not so ideal situations. Another great option with these microphones is to use them individually for other recording needs. For example, I'm using one of these microphones right now as a voiceover broadcast mic, and the results are great because it focuses the sound on the front of the mic, which is where I'm talking, and diminishes the background noise. You can still hear some, but it's not as much to allow for my voice to be front and center. You can also use these microphones individually on instruments like a piano or accompaniment instruments for the choir. In this example, I did just that, where I had access to a second stereo pair, which I used to record the choir's voices. And then I used the Samson CO2s and separated them, using one to mic the piano and the other to mic the soloists as they stepped in front of the choir. The pianos were behind the choir and the soloists were sometimes in front, so this was a bit of a challenge to capture the sound, but again, the CO2s did a great job. I will caution though, be careful when moving the mics away from each other too far apart. This can cause unwanted phasing issues between the mics. If you're getting this while listening back to your recording, try moving the mics closer together or going back to one of the previous techniques we talked about, either the stereo XY or the ORTF. We mentioned earlier having the need for making an audition recording or just recording a rehearsal. A lot of auditions are being handled strictly with video and audio clips these days. A great combination to have on hand for this would be the Samson CO2 mic pair and the Zoom Q8 Handy video recorder. The reason this is such a great combination is making those auditions requires audio and video straight out of camera, no effects or edits. Using an iPhone or a GoPro can give some pretty poor audio quality when recording live instruments or vocals, and this could make or break your audition. In our video about the Q8, we mentioned that you're getting pro audio in an affordable camera. Well, add on these great pro microphones, and you're gonna get great sounding recordings with video synced right out of camera. The great part here is that you can use these microphones in any of the previous techniques we mentioned, as well as splitting them to, say, capture the vocalist or a piano or the entire group. Lots of great options with this combination. So that's our overview of the Samson CO2 stereo microphone pair that you can get at jwpepper.com. We hope you found something useful in this video. All the products we talked about here today are in the description below, and these techniques can be used with other stereo mic pairs as well. As you can see, this pair can give you great results even in less than ideal situations. And we know that teachers and directors don't always get to choose how and where they'll perform. But if you want to make a good recording, hopefully these microphones will help you out. If you did find this video helpful, please give us a thumbs up. Leave us a comment below if you'd like to see more videos like this one, or tell us about some of the great ways that you record your ensemble. We'd love to hear about it and share it with others. You can also hit us up on social media. We're always engaging with our followers there, or you can give us a call and actually talk to a real person to answer any questions you might have. And don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss any of the new content we have coming out at JW Pepper.